I grew up with Sholay. I remember, you know, watching Sholay almost every night. Jay and Viru is always in my mind. His photos not being here is because we were asked to move out of the house. I was once asked that what is my favorite dish, and I mentioned Vakkomanda, that's the pumpkin pork. So now everywhere I go, it's always cooked. So yes, in one way I think like I shouldn't have said it. I was in a cabinet meeting and he just kept calling, and you know, there were 20 missed calls. So I just picked up and said, I'm in the cabinet meeting, you know, call me later. So he said, that's fine, so just top up my phone.
You always had time to watch films, and you watched Sholay 300 times.
Yeah, must be around that much, yeah.
Around that much. Now tell me about your fascination for Amitabh Bachchan and your fascination for Deepika Padukone.
I like Bollywood, so that's what it is. And I grew up, you know, when I was in Delhi, when my father was the Member of Parliament here. So I remember, you know, watching Sholay almost every night. So I grew up with Sholay, you know, so that remains in my mind a lot, you know, and Jay and Viru is always in my mind. So therefore, from there only the, you know, appreciation and the liking for, you know, Mr. Amitabh Bachchan started. And of course, Deepika Padukone also is a very beautiful actress, and she's a good actress. And I think that is something also that I like. I like watching her movies.
Have you met Mr. Amitabh Bachchan or Deepika Padukone
in
person?
No, never. I've never met. I mean, they're at a different level, and you know, we are of course at a different level. So I think they're celebrities, and it's their, I mean, their life is different, and I'm sure much more demanding, you know, than ours. And we are here with public life, so I think it's quite different. So I don't get an opportunity. It would be nice to meet them someday, but I have not met them yet. Absolutely, absolutely. I think Priyanka Chopra is, in fact, brand ambassador for Assam. And just I think 4 days back, Salman Khan had gone to Michuca in Arunachal Pradesh. And I think yes, it leads to also a lot of integration for the country. And more importantly, Northeast is a destination for tourism. And I think the more we can connect Bollywood to that, not only in terms of branding, but also in terms of making movies out there, I think people will be able to see what Northeast is, the beauty, the natural beauty that we have.
One of your MLAs called you in a cabinet meeting and said, top up my phone.
Not my MLA, one worker. It was one worker and one party leader, of course. I mean, from a village. I was in a cabinet meeting and he just kept calling, and you know, there were 20 missed calls, so I had to pick up the call. So I just picked up and said, I'm in the cabinet meeting, you know, call me later. So he said, that's fine, just top up my phone. So I said, so that's how politics is out there. But of course, it doesn't happen so much that often. People are very close to you, and once they connect to you, you know, they don't really look at you as a member of parliament or a minister or a chief minister. What is important to them is that they know you, and they expect you to always be the same in whatever position you are.
You have a favorite pork dish.
Mm.
And now you have got so bored that everywhere you go, they serve that dish. So you
absolutely
are not bored about it.
No, it's not about being bored. But yes, I was once asked that what is my favorite dish, and I mentioned Vakkomanda, that's the pumpkin pork. So people read that interview, I guess, and so now every meeting I go to, it's a must that the dish is there. So now everywhere I go, it's always cooked. So yes, in one way I think like I shouldn't have said it.
Did you ever think life will take such a turn? You lost your father, there was a void, and then you stepped into his shoes. What is the burden of history that you carry?
Well, of course, I did not expect, it was something that none of us expected, and it was very sudden. It was a very difficult moment for all of us, in fact, the whole family and the party. And I think at least that situation also brought everybody together also in one way. Coming into somebody's shoes like Mr. P.S. Sangma is not easy, and expectations are very high. What he can do with just one meeting and with one phone call, or you know, just simply meeting few people, it would take us days and days and months to do the same thing. So, of course, his image, his brand, and when he said something, people listened.
There is one criticism and one feeling that you upstaged your siblings and left James and Agatha behind to be chief minister.
It was not my decision alone. And we jointly decided that I should take over as party president, which was, you know, very important at that point. We had to decide. So they all decided together. We have been very united that way and supportive of each other, especially in, you know, in tough situations like that. It was a joint decision, number one. Number two, when it came to the chief minister's post, I didn't have any intentions to go to state politics. As I said, I was here working towards building my party, which is the responsibility that people had given me. I was working as a member of parliament, which is again a responsibility. People gave me a huge mandate. So I was working in that line. But I think the situation that happened out there, the coalition partners and all the other political parties, MLAs who were there, they had a desire that I should lead. And if I lead, then they were ready to support. So we had to make a very quick decision at that point, and that's why I came in. And I think all of us were on board in that decision also.
What has the chief ministership taken away from you? One thing is that your family lives in Delhi while you are there. So you're like a weekend father to both your daughters.
Well, it's not even the weekend. Maybe once a month I get a chance to come here. It's not just me. I think many people have to face the same challenges. It does help me in one way that I can focus a lot on work when I'm back in Shillong. So I can just be in the office, you know, from 10 to 10. And there's not much to disturb me. So that way it's good, but yes, it's difficult sometimes being away from family.